how to know when to say it, when to change it. Certain things God show you, you can pray and change it. Some things you can't change. There are some prophetic words that are conditional, and there are some that are unconditional. And if ever given an opportunity of the Lord giving the grace to allow it, I'll do it. But the first thing I need you to understand in the life of the prophetic, for it to be pure, authentic, genuine, so that the compassion of God can flow through you in the process. There's sometimes you may see me prophesying, I go weeping. There's sometimes you see me prophesying, I'm just having a good time. Sometimes you see me prophesying, and I'm frowning in a smile. I want to get you to a place in the prophetic that when you prophesy, I'm going to say something deep now, catch this. There's a realm of the prophetic you can step in where there's a certain realm I step in where I am.
That's good. Amen.
Oh, please. There's a certain realm I get into where it ain't even me no more.
That's good.
But God possesses my body.
Yeah.
And begin to talk through it.
That's good.
That's why God told Jeremiah, don't be afraid of their faces. Don't even worry about what you're going to say. Just open your mouth. And guess what? I'll feel it. So there's a realm in the prophetic where I began to pray the Holy Ghost, and God will literally tabernacle my flesh. And there's another poem as I begin to prophesy, for ye I say unto thee, you've not seen such and such, and my glory shall cover the earth. And I'm saying my glory, but you that know, no, I ain't talking about my glory because I ain't got no glory. But it's God possessing my body. You want God to possess your body?
Yeah, that's good.
How many of you know people are demon possessed? Amen. So if somebody can be possessed by a demon, why not be possessed by the Holy Ghost? There's a realm that I tap into in the prophetic. There's a certain place I get into when I tap into a certain realm, right? Well, the reason I can look at somebody and know their name, know their address, know their phone number, there's a certain realm I get to in the prophetic, right? Where whatever come to me, I know it's him because it ain't me no more.
Wow.
So if I look at somebody and Josh come to me, I'm not even channeling or trying to decipher whether it's God.
That's good.
Because I've yielded my members to him.
Wow. Yes.
So even every thought that I think becomes his thought. Yes. So when I get in that level of the prophetic, it's dangerous because I can think about somebody and the minute I think about them, they'll call me.
That's right.
Wow.
Some of you have experienced it at a certain level, and God's trying to teach you how to be sensitive to him. Yeah. There's a realm you can tap into where I'm telling you, you just say things. See, get to a place where you become prophetic by accident.
That's good.
All that I ever say. Get to a place,
wow,
where you go to saying stuff and you think you just talking.
Wow.
Not recognizing you become so yielded to him that even what you thought you were saying by accident was on purpose. Y'all got that? But the key to that is worship. And I'm talking about genuine worship. And what I've been really teaching people is how to wait in his presence. Because most of us go in the presence of God and we're in a rush.
Yeah.
And we bring a chair. And we don't know how to wait. When I get ready to worship, when I'm in my prayer time with the Lord, sometimes I play music. But guess what? Sometimes music is a distraction.
It's good.
So I get a chair, I sit on the floor, whatever, and I sit there. And I wait. Now, most of you are not willing to go through the waiting process. out for his presence. You go right in. Father, I bless you. But remember, Psalm 82:18 says you got to quicken you.
Yeah.
See, your spirit can't communicate to God without his quickening. So you go right in. You go right on with Sasujiye. Father, I just bless you. Halabasi, calm down on the whole time. You do all that, right? That's fine. But I promise you, if you learn to go in your room and be still before him and wait, just sit there. And I wait on him. Like I say, I play worship music. Sometimes I get in the most quiet part of the house I can find. Find me a closet and just wait. And how long do you wait? You wait until his presence becomes so real that it's more real than the room you sit in.
That's good.
But guess why we don't want to wait? Because in that waiting time, that's when your flesh dies. Imagine your flesh want to go to Walmart. Your flesh got place to go, and you just sit there and wait. I'm not going to move. It's in that moment that he's stripping stuff off of you. And most of you don't understand, when it comes to the prophetic, God cannot talk to a vessel who is still alive. Because as long as you're alive, he got too much to compete with. I got to compete with what you're thinking about. I got to compete with what's on your mind. I got to compete. That's why the key to authentic prophetic, and I'll show you some things. But the key to the prophetic, how I was able to prophesy in Jackson and tell Jackson who was going to be the mayor. How I was able to prophesy all of these things going on with the election. How you be knowing that? When you hear that, what you see? Prophesy, how you do it? The key to that is solitude. The key to the prophetic with accurate precision is getting by yourself. If you can never show, some of you never tap into it because you like to be around people too much. And prophetic people don't hang with a crowd. Prophetic people know how to walk by yourself. Say amen. Are you hearing me? So learn how to hush. What? Be still. Learn how to get somewhere and don't open your mouth. Cut people off for 3 days. Go on a mouth fast. What do you mean? Don't talk. Go on a fast where you don't say nothing. Don't spend no time with nobody. You just get by yourself. I went to go see this lady the other day, and I thought about it. I said, can you imagine, if you shut your TV off, if you didn't talk on, if you shut the TV off for 7 days, if you didn't look at social media for 7 days, if you didn't talk on the phone for 7 days, can you imagine how clear your thoughts would be? But some of you cannot tap into that place of precision where he's able to transcend into your thoughts because he's fighting social media. Y'all quiet.
It's good.
He's fighting too much. Give God an empty mind that he can talk to. Lay hands on your head and say, Lord, I give you my mind. Say it again. Lord, I give you my mind. Most of us sit in church and open up a text. Sit in church looking at social media. Quiet. God compete with too much. Just imagine, some of you can't sit in church for a certain amount of time without moving, without looking at something. And when you see somebody who don't have enough discipline to turn that phone off, enough discipline to not, some of y'all can't even drive without looking at your phone. You have no discipline. Catch this. When you can't control control your mouth. Always primitive. You show me somebody who can't control their tongue, I show you somebody who has no discipline in other areas of their life. If you don't control this, you can't control nothing else. Y'all quiet. James 3 says your tongue is a what? Unruly man. If you show me somebody, if you can, that's what I've been telling the Lord to help me do. I really want, you know, I saw Brother Copeland one time sitting in the room, you know, and you need to get to a place, and I'm going to let this go, where you, give me now, it's maturity. You got to get to a place in God where you measure your words.
It's good.
You don't just talk the talk. A lot of people just be talking and don't need to be talking about nothing. Get to a place where every word you say, when you say it, there's a reason for you to say it. Because remember, every idle word you speak, you got to give an account for it. So even the stuff you say, you be like, I was just playing. God said, you got to give an account for that. Y'all quiet, y'all quiet.
That's good.
So get to a place where you, 1 Peter 3 and 4 says that a woman has a meek and quiet spirit. And I told the Lord, I don't just want it in a woman. I told God, give me a meek and quiet spirit. I want to get to a place. You want to be so meek and so quiet that when you do talk, everybody listens. Some of you talk so much, when you go to talk to them, I pay you no attention. Oh, then she's going to talk to me again. Ain't that me? Are y'all hearing me? Let me ask the Lord, help me to measure my words. Say it again. Lord, help me to measure my words. Another thing, increase your vocabulary. That's what Apostle Eckhart taught me. Increase your spiritual vocabulary. What that mean? Some of you can't prophesy on a certain level because your vocabulary naturally is limited. Some of you may have the book, but some of you may not have it. I don't know if we had a book, the vault is open. But if you listen to the language, even though it's the Holy Ghost writing and God was talking, if I didn't have that in my spirit, the Holy Ghost would have nothing to pull on. Remember now, he brings all things back to your what? The Holy Ghost is like a computer. If you don't download nothing, ain't nothing for him to give you. Right now, if you come in my room, the only thing you're going to see my TV on is CNN. That's all I'm watching right now. Every time, all I'm going to see is, because I need to know the news. Why? Because I got to feel my spirit with it, so I'm in a position to hear God about it. Make sense? Some of you, God can't speak to you about China, because you don't know what's going on in China. He can't speak to you about Argentina and other nations, because you don't know what's going on about it. So what you got to do? You got to feel your spirit. Don't be a dumb prophet.
It's good.
Don't be dumb in the prophetic when all you can do is tell people God gonna move for you. God told me today he's gonna turn your situation around. God told me today you ain't seen nothing yet. God told me today he's gonna be double for your trouble. It's your time to shine. The president of the United States, and he needs to hear a word from the Lord. He don't got time for you to quit. Come on, y'all. I'm trying to get you get
that's
this.
Good.
I need you to get to a place where you live in the flow.
Wow.
When the president says, I need a word from the Lord, you hope I'm home, Mr. President. You come out of the house. I come out of this. No, get in a position where you can look at the president. Yeah, I say unto thee that I shall begin to redirect and reestablish your goings and bring it to where the Holy Ghost can, where that word can come out of you like a fountain. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Some of you, you stand before the president, you don't know policies, so God can't talk to you about it.
That's good.
That's good.
You don't keep up with the news, you keep up with reality TV. But you don't keep up with foreign policy, what's going on in the world, what's going on with the candidates. So God can't speak to you about it, because if you're not interested in it, God is not, God God is not obligated to make you interested in what's not important to you. I need you to be, I need you to get a burden for the nation.
Right.
And if you get a burden for the nation, I'll talk to you about that nation.
Yeah, that's good.
Y'all don't like this, huh? Look at him and say, Lord, give me a burden for America. Come on, say, Lord, give me a burden for my family. You know when you get a burden for your family, God will talk to you about your family? He'll tell you what your daughter about to do. He'll speak you in a dream and show you your son got plans to do something, he ain't got no business. Why? Because whatever you have a burden for is what he'll reveal to you. Come on now.
Yeah.
What you interceding for? What you believe in God for? God will show you the secret thing. That's what I tell you. Lord, I want to know people's secrets. I tell you, here recently, I've taken a burden for missing people. I told God, show me where the missing folk at. People get folk missing 10, 15, they go to psychics.
Yeah.
Sylvia Brown got on TV, that old chick did, that bitch. You know, now on Montel. Came on there and said that Amanda Berry was dead. They found in Cleveland. She was in the house. And they believed that witch. Are y'all hearing me? Another, they said, who kidnapped this person? She said, it's a Spanish man. It's a Spanish man. He got locks in his head. And when y'all find him, they're going to see. They found the man. He was white as white could be. Amen. We need somebody who can see. We need seers. We need legitimate seers that when somebody's son go missing, they can go find him a prophet.
That's good.
Come on, y'all. That's what happened. In the 9th chapter of 1 Samuel, they had donkeys that was missing. Huh? We need to find them. They said, hold on. We heard there's a man of God in the city.
That's good.
My God, they call him a seer. He said, hold on. No, hold on now. If we going to put on this gift, we got to make sure we honor him right. What shall we bring the prophet? I'm in the book, y'all. And he may tell us our way. When they went to the prophet to find out where their donkeys was, guess what happened? That prophet told them where he was. Where them prophets at? These are the prophets we need. You don't need no prophet to tell God to give you a car. Tell me where the car at. What dealership to go to? I'm sick of going to all these other dealerships and getting rejected. Show me where I'm going to go and get approved. Come on, y'all hearing me?
That's good.
Precision. And so my desire, and today we're going to activate you, but my desire is for you to get to a place in the prophetic where you confidently hear the voice of God, and some of you got to really understand what the prophetic is. Really get it. The prophetic is not just telling you God gonna bless you.
Yeah.
You need to understand the purpose of the prophetic.
Yeah.
The office of the prophetic.
Yeah.
Tyrone, I'm gonna need another mic. The office of the prophetic, the reason for the prophetic. Ron, do you understand that?
Yeah.
Alright.
So I'm gonna let Prophet Ferguson come up here. He's gonna talk to you about the prophetic. He got a book called Prophet 101. He's gonna talk about a matter of fact. Everybody today. He's gonna share some things with you. Everybody today, when you get out of service. How much is your book? It's on Amazon?
It's on Amazon.
It's on Amazon. But he big time. I haven't made Amazon yet. But he had a book on Amazon called Prophets 101.
Yeah.
How much is it? About 12 hours?
About 12 hours.
Okay. Listen, it helped me. So you folk, now remember this. Look at me. When God began to deal with me in the prophetic, I studied. I went and got Bill Hammond's books. You can't say you're interested in something and want to invest time in it.
Right.
Good. I had a friend of mine, we got ready to go to a conference, and you know, it was actually one of Bishop Gates a couple of years ago, which was for the young people, and I went, and my friend went to go with me. And it was like 3 or 4 weeks back. He wanted me to pay his way. And I said, if you don't care about your future enough,
yeah,
that you're willing to invest. us $300, don't waste your time and go. What's wrong with us? We want everything for nothing. Y'all quiet. So invest in your future. What you love, you invest in. Amen. When I got it, started shooting pool, I bought about 200 sticks. Amen. I started shooting, I started getting my stick, getting my glove, getting my chalk. And I was showing up, had all the stuff, couldn't shoot pool at all. But when I came, like, we can shoot pool. They ain't know, they didn't want to shoot pool with me. But I invested in it. And I invested in it, and I kept doing it until same thing when I got in the bowl. Man, I bought so many balls. Every time you see me, I was buying a ball. Every city I went, I was buying a ball. Because whatever you love, guess what? You start investing in it. Get a love for, I love the prophetic. Because I love the prophetic that if I can be in a store, and I don't even plan on buying a book about the prophetic. If I see a new book about the prophetic, guess what? I'm going to buy it. Why? Because there may be something in it, I don't know. I don't think that I have mastered the prophetic. And God has gifted me so strongly in the prophetic that the Lord told me one time, Pastor Brown told me this for minutes. He said, prophet, God used you to raise the bar of the prophetic in America. Okay, now I'm going to say something. There was a time when people prophesied, you didn't hear them calling out names. That was real rare. Not everybody doing it. A lot of them getting it off of Facebook and Twitter and all that stuff. They ain't real, they Facebook prophets, you understand? But God used me to raise the bar of the prophetic so high that people compare themselves to it. And I tell people, don't compare. Let me tell you something. I know some prophets who are extremely accurate, but never call a name. They never call an address. But when they prophesy to you, they come down on your street. They get all in your business, and you get everything but call by name. You hear me? So, but no matter how much God has used me in the prophetic, God has shown me in the prophetic, I've not got to a place where I can't learn some more. So always keep a spirit of humility where God can teach you. And who want to learn some more? I mean, who want to learn more? I mean, who want to know the voice of God like you know your name? I could go through the supermarket and say, hey, her name is so-and-so. Hey, so-and-so, I call her name, look around, I just keep walking, praise God. But I want you to get that way. So, Prophet Ferguson, and get this back. Now, you know Prophet Ferguson. Who heard of Prophet Ferguson before? Give him a great big back. Now, you know when Prophet Ferguson ministered, you got to catch it. What you want to get this, write this stuff down, but he preaches by revelation. Revelation cannot be taught, it got to be caught. Hello, shout, hey. Okay, so get this. He's going to teach us something about the prophetic, then I'm going to activate, he's going to teach about 30 minutes in the prophetic, 35 minutes, 40 in the most. And then we're going to activate you in the prophetic. You ready? Who want everything God got for you? Come on, give Prophet Ferguson a great big round of applause.